Hello, my name is John Sunderland.
And I'm Josh Stepchak.
And we'll be talking to you today about cross-cultural listening and how it affects your time here at Iowa State.
And beyond.
In today's global climate, it is commonplace to interact with people of many different cultures in our daily lives. Even children in their earliest days of school start to interact with different cultures. Whether these differences are religious, national, or even political, children are introduced to new ideas and challenges that crossing cultural boundaries always entail. Here at ISU, or any diverse institution for that matter, cultural interactions become a matter of success or failure. Listening to cultural differences is necessary for any major because business doesn't always happen in your own backyard. Agriculture isn't just for the South, and engineering concepts apply regardless of what hemisphere you're in. We are lucky here at ISU to have people with so many diverse backgrounds to work with every day. If you listen carefully, you can learn a lot about yourself and this world in which we live. Taking the time to listen and understand different cultures builds communication skills that are invaluable to our social, personal, and professional lives. We must understand the differences between ourselves and others. We must understand differences in all forms of communication that we use. And we must understand that no matter how different cultures may be, we cannot assume one is greater than another. Now we invite you to be journey riders on our exploration of culture here at Iowa State and beyond.
Here is the individualist view of self. It starts out with the self, and then mother, father, friend, sibling. Notice how all the groups are spread out and they're not connected. An example of some individualist cultures are the United States, England, and Australia. Next, we have the collectivist view of self. The collectivist view of self starts out with the self, a mother, father, sibling, and friend. Notice how these are all together and they're connected and they're a unit. Some collectivist cultures are India and Japan. Next, we have a survival guide for collectivists in an individualist culture. Tip number one, pay more attention to other person's personal beliefs and principles rather than his or her groups. They pride themselves on being individuals. Tip number two, expect members to be more horizontal thinking when it comes to relationships. Vertical thinking is seeking out solutions based on knowledge and ideas. However, horizontal thinking is brainstorming. Horizontal relationships are based on equality, but vertical relationships are based on superiors. Tip number three, relationships will be superficial, short-termed, but with good intentions. Hey, what's up? How's it going? Not too much. All right. Talk to you later. Bye. Things like that. Tip number four, beware of the dog-eat-dog mentality, i.e. competition is big. Tip number five, expect business opportunities shortly after acquaintances. We want results. We want to make deals, and we'll do it fast. Tip number six, value written agreements over informal agreements. Say one thing, but get it in writing just for sure. Tip number seven, time is money. Everything is fast-paced and going quickly. Tip number eight, by allowing you to be free, they're expressing confidence in you. It's all about being individuals. Tip number nine, rewards are distributed evenly or by a need basis. Tip number 10, status is focused on accomplishments. It's not based on age or sex as much as you're used to. It's what you've done.
In business settings, we have so many forms of communication, it's hard to use them all correctly within your own building. So trying to communicate across nations properly seems like an incredibly daunting task. With a few helpful tips and some practice, you'll be culturally savvy in your communication in no time at all. I am sure you know that it is improper to write a memo the same way you would write a text message. The same logic can be applied to communication with international associates. Do not add cultural references to your communications. This can cause confusion and distort your message by adding unnecessary noise. Just like telling your grandmother TTYL, telling a foreign business associate a stitch in time saves nine, or a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush, can cause a lot of unnecessary explaining. Imagine talking to a Swedish counterpart and hearing, "The afternoon knows what the morning never suspected." Would you know what they were talking about immediately? It is also important to be formal, whether you are writing or talking. You would not talk to your new boss the same way you talk to an old friend. What rules of formality do you use? Only the rules that you are familiar with. Do not try to emulate the formality of other cultures unless you know what you are doing. It would be very embarrassing to get confused about whether to use Madame and or Monsieur when talking to a French associate. Business professionals will prefer to be respected in your native culture than disrespected in their own, no matter how good your intentions are. Whether you are writing a letter, sending an email, making a phone call, or meeting face-to-face, it is important to keep in mind that you are building intercultural partnerships and you are representing more than just yourself. You are representing your company. Cultural relevance goes beyond just working with people. Technology has different cultures as well. The 1998 Mars orbiter crashed into the Martian atmosphere due to engineers entering English units into a program built for metric units. Even using Skype is different than meeting face to face. You have to worry about what is in the background and ensure that you have reliable computer and internet access. You must also dress appropriately and still remember to speak formally. Memos sent within a company may reach offices all over the world, so you have to keep all the rules of cultural interactions in mind, even though you only plan on sending the memo to the people within your office.
I need you in my office.
Todd, we decided to restructure order fulfillment. Offshore the whole department.
We need you in India.
No way, no. I'm not going to India to train my own replacement.
All you need to do is visit the call center and make sure the new guy's up to speed.
Bro, what is that?
Oh, that is just a cow. Must have wandered in. 1 minute.
Basically, you people need to learn about America. Hold your nose to flatten the vowel like Chicago.
Chicago.
Not a good time.
Buddy, I assure you, I'm in Chicago.
Yeah, right.
Bro, this place is a disaster.
Hey!
I'll be stuck in India the rest of my life. My name is Todd. Everyone says Toad.
Are you Mr. Toad?
Mr. Toad.
Mr. Toad, I'll see.
Did you realize you're not on vacation over there?
Yeah, like I would come here for vacation.
Listen, Todd, just a word of advice. I remember feeling like you do. I was resisting India. Once I gave in, I did much better.
It was a pleasure talking with you.
Bahut badhiya kar.
Some things I don't understand about American life. You hate your boss, and you don't like this company. Why not choose something else?
Why didn't you say anything?
Why didn't you say anything? I don't know how this country works.
Watch out! You must jump!
Hi. I don't know how to explain it. In my world, it just makes sense to work your ass off just so you can have that 50-inch plasma.
Someone's got to train the new guy.
Some of us do sound alike. There are over 1 billion of us, you know.
That's terrible.
Americans don't really know how good they have it then.
Dude, most of them don't. Most of them don't. People who do drive like 1990, year old cars, probably even 80s for the most part. And here people are driving 2002 car and they're freaking out about it.
Being old or whatever.
Being old, yeah. And here's these people fixing, they fix their own cars. Any problems that you, they fix by himself, it's not.
So it's a lot with the work ethic then?
Everything is done by the man. It's really weird.
Not that pride or...
Here it's like, when your son's 18, you pick him out.
Mm-hmm.
For my family, it's not like that. I don't know, maybe just because the tradition came on over. Usually when son turns 18, in Bosnia, they don't have a lot of options.
Mm-hmm.
So over there, when their son is 18 and wants to get married, they get married and they live with their parents.
Sure.
So different rooms, you know, the little kind of room or whatever. It's, but here, girls, not girls, but in general, everybody's moving to a house or apartment right away and live together. It doesn't work like that. Things don't work.
More fast-paced here.
Yeah, it is more fast-paced too. Over there you can enjoy a full day.
Mm-hmm.
A full day feels like 3 days. Here, a full day feels like 24 hours, fast-paced.
Yeah.
That's what I mean.
What about you?
Well, you.
Yeah, right.
When was the last time anybody, I mean the majority of people that live in the U.S. use accidental calculation by hand instead of a calculator? I mean, so it's different when you have those tools available. You tend to go for it right away instead of actually thinking twice or doing it in your head.
Yeah, and well, there's a lot of multitasking with everything that's going on.
Yeah, that's true. There's a lot of multitasking here. Over where I'm from, that day when you're set to do that one thing, you're going to get that one thing done regardless if it takes 24 hours.
Mm-hmm.
And it doesn't matter. Here, it's kind of split up. Oh, if I don't get this done today, I got to start working on this, I do this. It's kind of like a break thing, and then later on you finish it, you know. Over there, you can do this the whole day, and I don't care if it takes. It doesn't matter how long it takes.
You pick it up, and you get it done.
You get it done. That's the bottom line. At least that's where I'm from. I mean, maybe some parts of from Bosnia is different, but at least from my region, that's how it is for the most part. Not everybody's like that, though. I mean, there's always... Everybody's not the same. I can't compare myself to everybody, but at least that's how my family is. You pick up one thing, you get it done.
Well, is that kind of how you see, like, you know, America being more, like, rushed than, you know, being relaxed and that?
Yeah, you don't, that's where it comes in, where, like, you don't really think twice before you do it. You kind of just do it. Dude, I can give you a joke off the top of my head. I mean, that's but I mean, just random jokes that are funny here would not be funny over there. They would look at you like,
what's wrong with
like,
you?
Yeah. And if I cracked a joke from over there, here, they would look at me like, what the hell is wrong with me?
Yeah.
And vice versa. And I know this because I've tested it.
Oh, cool.
So I went by and I tried to crack a joke and it failed. it wasn't funny at all, so, I don't enjoy going out over there. I like the fact that I can go over there and I can have fun.
Yeah.
Here's the, you know, drinking age. I don't drink much anyways.
Yeah.
But I just like to have the option. If I want to take a beer, buy a beer, I want to drink one beer. But I'm not an alcoholic.
Yeah.
You know, so.
You know your level.
Yeah, it's like here, it's like everybody, they have everything, you know, if you choose to, but just don't cherish it, I guess. I guess here they take, some people take things for granted, which is not right.
Fitting into the culture any differently, like over
here,
like you're more. You feel like you're an alien a little bit more, or
no? When I first was here, I felt like I was judged, like I'm not accepted, or you know. But then after a while, you don't get used to. I mean, I feel normal. I feel like I'm part of this because I'm
American.
I am an American. I would call myself an American. think of what has happened. What has happened?